Sam here from CreativeMinds. In this video, we are discussing the Download Manager micropayment integration, which adds a virtual currency layer to your download directory infrastructure, which means that when a user downloads or uploads a file, such as a music file or a software zip file, they will be charged a specific amount of points that will then be deducted from their virtual wallet.
After installing both the Micropayments and the Downloads Manager plugins, the first thing you will need to do in order to complete the integration is to go to the Micropayments settings and add point values. Here you can determine exactly how many points are worth a certain amount of any currency. The default is US dollars. For example, we have points values at 100 for one US dollar and 500 for five US dollars. You can also easily add as many other point values as you like. This is the virtual currency that your site's users can use to either gain or charge points for downloading or uploading with the Downloads Manager. After you have established point values in the micropayment settings, you can head over to the Downloads Manager settings. You should see a micropayments tab appear. Under the micropayment settings, you can decide what kind of micropayment transactions will accompany either downloads or uploads by users. For downloads, you can choose to disable the micropayment platform, to grant points to the user's wallet, or to withdraw or charge points from the user's wallet. You can also set up a specific amount for individual downloads. Below, you can define the default amount of points to be withdrawn or added to the user's wallet. The same settings apply for when a user uploads a file to the download repository, except that you cannot specify a points value for uploads. Back in the micropayment settings, if we go into PayPal, you can choose to run the plugin on test mode. Your user on this settings page will put in their PayPal email. The user can also put in a PayPal style if they so choose. This means that any of their transactions on your site will be directly linked to their PayPal account. Under the general settings, you can generate wallets for existing users and assign wallets to customers. You can also decide whether or not you want to be able to charge inactive wallets. You can also activate the micropayment dashboard widget. And this is important if we go to payment currency. As you can see, you can choose from a variety of currencies. In fact, almost every single currency in the world. Under notifications, you can check the box for send notifications, and this means that you will be notified of every transaction involving your wallet. You can also customize emails for when points have been withdrawn or added to your wallet. There are several shortcodes available that custom tailor these emails. For example, we have the amount of points and the withdrawer ID, which is how many points you have left in your wallet. So now let's see what it looks like for the user when they visit the downloads page on your WordPress site. When they click on a particular download of interest, for example, this music download, they can preview the download as usual, but the user will be notified of the pricing of the individual download and will not be able to download the file unless they have enough points. If the user doesn't have enough points in their wallet to download the file, they can easily access their individual wallet in order to purchase enough points to download the file. At checkout, the user will be able to choose from among the point values that you have assigned, and they can charge their wallet this way. When the user has sufficient points in their wallet to purchase the download, under the download button on the download page, it will alert the user of the price of the download, and the user can go ahead and download the file. If you choose to set the points value for each individual download, then when the administrator goes to create a new download, you will have an option at the end of the form to either disable, grant, or charge a certain number of points to the user that is catered to that specific download. Now let's see what it looks like for a user when they want to upload a file. On the My Downloads page, a user can choose to add a new download. For example, I will add a download here. You can give it a name, version, upload one or more files, enable single file download, a preview or media player if applicable, assign it to one or more categories, give it one or more tags, provide a description, a screenshot, among all of the other options available with the Download Manager plugin. Then when you go to add the download, you can see that the 300 points have been added to my wallet, because that is the point value we set for when users add a new download to the repository. Once you have added the download, you can view it and see that other users will be charged 500 points to download it. You can also view your wallet for proof that the 300 points were added to your wallet in your transaction history.